Dear student, today we will discuss concept of concurrency control. In last video we discussed concept of transaction management, where we discussed the different four main properties of transaction management: asset property, that is related to atomic, consistency, isolation and durability. Today we will discuss about the concurrency control. What is the concurrency control? Concurrency control, that is the process of managing simultaneous operation against a database so that data integrity is maintained and the operation do not interfere with each other in a multi-user environment. So concurrency control, that is the process of managing simultaneous operations against a database. Right? Whenever different users are there, they are performing simultaneous operations. Concurrent operations are performed with the database. Right? So what have to do the database? We have to maintain the database integrity. Right? So that the process of managing simultaneous operation against a database, so that database or data integrity is maintained. Right? So that process is known in the multi-user environment. Whenever we are having the multi-user environment is there, multi-user have to access the data, have to perform the different operation. So in such environment we must have to maintain the database integrity or data integrity. We have to maintain the correctness and accuracy of the data, that is known as concurrency control. When more than one transaction is being processed against a database at the same time, transaction are said to be concurrent transaction. So we have the concept of concurrent transactions, all of those transactions that are performed at the same times with the database. Whenever user have to perform, user have to process different multiple transactions, more than one transaction at the same time against a database, those transactions are known as concurrent transactions. So multiple transactions are performed at the same time in multi-user environment known as concurrent transaction. In database environment, several users have to access the data and manipulate data at the same time. So we may have the different size and complexity of the data, we may have the multiple user of the database, those users have to perform the different operation with the database. So whenever multiple users have to perform the database, then all of those are performing, those transactions that are performing at the same time in multi-user environment are known as concurrent transactions. The database without concurrency control will be compromised due to interference between the users, as whenever multiple users have to perform the different operation, simultaneous operation at the same times, then database integrity may be compromised if we don't have a concurrency control. So concurrency control is very important. That is the process of managing simultaneous operation against a database. We must have to maintain the data integrity. Now when we say that why we need the need for the concurrency control, so concept of need for the concurrency control, we have two main points or sometimes three main points that are considered. One is last update problems, and second one is we are having inconsistent read problems. Last update problem, and second one we have a inconsistent read problems. First one, last update problems, and second one, inconsistent read problems. Last update problem, this problem is related to, this problem arises when multiple users attempt to update the database without having the concurrency control. When we are having the multiple users are there and they are attempting to database and they don't have a any control, any concurrency control, that problem is known as a lost update problems. Let's take an example related to lost update problem on PowerPoints. We have a lost update problem. Let we are having the two different users are there. Those users have to perform those operations. Let one user is John, second one is the Mashra. We have to perform the different operations. Lost update operations, let at the same time both the users have to perform the transaction with database, right? Let one user read the account balance and balance is displayed that is $1,000. That user is here John, right? At the same time another user is reading the balance and it also display same balance to the users Mashra and that is $1,000. After some time user A John withdraw some amount from the account balance. So it's we see that he withdraw the amount of the 2000, right? What will be happened? Remaining balance is here 800 and then we have Mashra, then he withdraw the amount of the 7300 and the balance is here 700. He write John's write the balance as well as this one write the balance. All then such a way database will be in inconsistent form. Let me again write all of these things over here in the form of table, so that will be much more clear to you people. We have two users are there, we are having two different transactions are there. First we are having the transaction 1 and transaction 2. Those are the two different users are there and those users are performing the different transactions at the same time. That we are having the user transaction T1 and second one transaction is here T2. At the transaction T1 user is here, let we are having the username is here Ali and second user transaction 2 that is performed by another user, the name of user is here Rafi. So two different users are available, those users have to perform the different transactions at the same time. What will be happened? User 1 have to read the balance, read balance and it display the amount of the balance that is both of these users, let we say that they are having the joint account. So balance will be displayed to both of these users that let we say that $1,000. Similarly, on the main while, another user Rafi also read the balance and it also display same joint account of both of these users is there. Both of users want to access the data from the same database, that is 1000. Now after some times Ali user want to withdraw the amount of 2000 from the bank account. So when he is withdrawing the amounts, no, still now he didn't write that one amount in a database. So meanwhile Rafi also withdraw the amount of $300. So now here Ali read the balance that was $1,000 and he withdraw the amount of the 200. So he write the balance, write will be here, that will be performed 1000 minus 200. So we are having the remaining amount that will be written over here and that is $800. While another user Rafi write it over here, write balance. So that balance will be here 1000 minus 300. That must be equal to 700 dollars. So whenever user have to commit it, if we are committing these value over here in a database, it's mean that here it writes it over at 800. Right, and if we checked it over here, it write it over here the 700. Any one values, if previous value that is written over here that is replaced by the new value, right? That problem is known as lost update problem, and database will be in the that is the error. That is the error. So why error? Reason is that one the Bing will be in loss if we don't have the concurrency control when multiple users have to access the data at the same time. The effect of lost update has been lost due to the interference between user transaction. Right? Effect of the lost update has been lost due to the interference between transaction. Simultaneous access can update to cancel each other. So whenever we are having the concept of concurrency control, so in such cases we may be able to control all of these things. Taking another example, we are having successfully completing update is overwritten by another user. When one user is updating the data, second user is updating the information, right? Let T1 withdraw the 10 euro from account balance, initially that was 100. Let transaction 1, we are having total balance was here 1000, so that detect the amount of 1000. T2, we are having the debt deposit 100, so in the account. So balance will should be here, that is a 190, right? But what will be happened, right? Let we say that two different transactions are there, T1 and T2. Balance is here, begin transaction, balance is here 100. Both of these transactions are reading the balance, that is a 100. First, whenever we are having the user is available at the transaction 2, he add the amount of 100, that become in over here 100 will be here, and then second one user is withdrawing the amount of 10 euro, so 100 minus 10, that will be here 90, while here it is writing it over here 100 plus 100 200. So first this one is write it over here 200, second one is write it over here 90, and that commit it over here. So it's mean whenever we are applying the different transaction at the same time, the effect of lost update is here, that is a 90. So this one 90 is right, that update the previous lost update values. So all lost updated value will be lost due to the interference between the transactions. So whenever loss of the T2 update avoided by prevented T1 for reading balance X until after update. So this one problem is known as lost update problems. Now we discuss the concept of the lost update problems. After that one we are having another problems, and those problem is called inconsistent read problems. Inconsistent read problems, the problems occur when one user read the data that has been partially updated by another user. Right? One user is reading the data and the second one user is partially, that data has been partially updated by another user. Like we are having the two different users are there, user A and user B. Both of users are performing the transaction at the same time. If one user is reading the data, while and that reading of the data is partially updated by another user, that concept is known as inconsistent read problems. Inconsistent read problem, that is related to the uncommitted dependency problems. That is related to the uncommitted. Dependency problem. Uncommitted dependency problems, when one transaction can see intermediate result of another transaction before it commit. Like whenever before committing the transactions, if one transaction see the result of another transaction, that problem is known as uncommitted dependency problem, and that is related to the inconsistent read problems. Inconsistent read problem, I already told you, the problem occur when one user reads the data. Inconsistent read problems, what we have, when one user reads the data that has been partially updated by another user. That problem is known as inconsistent read problems. And inconsistent read problem, we are having the uncommitted dependency problems. Uncommitted, when one transaction can see the intermediate result of another transaction before it has been committed. Let we are having the different transactions, or their user are performing the different transaction at the same time, and one transaction is viewing the data before the second transaction committed. Like we are taking the example over here. Let me take another insert the another table. Let we have to insert the few rows and okay. Let we having different times are there. Then we have a transaction 1 and transaction 2, and then we say that for balance. Time we are having the different times are available. Let we say that T1, T2, T3, then we have T4, T5, and T6. Transaction 1, we see that transaction 2, that is the begin transaction. And when transaction is begin, so we have a that display the balance, and balance was here, let we say that is a 100 euro, right. Now this one is a read balance. So when it reads the balance will be here, that is against 100. Now it's again we want to add it over here in the value of the balance. Balance is equal to balance plus 100. Balance equal to balance plus 100. Let me copy it. Balance plus 100. Let me manage the size also over here. The size will be here. Let decreasing over here. So balance is equal to balance plus 100. So now balance should be here. That should be 200, right? And then it write it over here balance. Still now that is the 100. When it write it over here, the balance will be 200, right? So balance will be here 200. Meanwhile, when it writes the balance over here, meanwhile another transaction is started, begin transaction by the transaction 1. Second user want to perform the transaction at the same time. When it second user read the transaction, we say that begin transaction. Begin transactions, so transaction will be begin. Now then it read the balance, so read balance amount will be here. Read balance amount will be that it read the amount of 200, as still now transaction is not completed yet, but it display the value over here. 200. Then second transaction read the data, it display the balance is here 200. Now after that one, this one user want to withdraw the amount, right? Now this one user withdraw the amount of the balance. Balance is equal to balance minus, let me see that 10 euro that want to withdraw, and at distance that should be over here 190, right? And at the meanwhile, this one users have to do, or we say that balance, this one user is, when it read it over here, it will roll back. When it roll back, balance will be, it displayed over here 100, but when next transaction is here, so let me say that time t we have 7. Now what will be over here, it when it write the balance, so write balance, it write the balance, it read the balance value over here, the 200 minus 10 190, right? And then this one user committed, we are having the commit. This when you, this user accept the transactions, it's mean it commit the value of 190 over here. Whenever multiple user have to access the data, right, and one user can see the intermediate result of another transaction before it has completed. So before the completion, when user have to access the data, that problem is known as uncommitted dependency problem or inconsistent read problems, right? So here, when it write it over here 190, it's mean that database is in inconsistent form. What value should be written over here, like we are having it when it's added over here 100, so balance is here 200, but that transaction is not completed, just that is rollbacked. When transaction is rollback, it's mean that value will be here 100, and again it's withdrawing the amount of $10 or €10, so amount should be here 190 euro, but sorry 90 euro, but we are writing it over here 190 euro. So that problem is known as uncommitted dependency problem, when one transaction can see intermediate result of another transactions before it has committed. So whenever we are having user out there, they are seeing, viewing the partial result, that may lead to the dependency, that may lead to the uncommitted dependency problem. To handle this problem, we are having the concept of serializability. We will discuss the concept of serializability in next video. Thanks for watching the video.